Numerix Video Blog. I'm your host, Jim Jocko. With me today, Tom Davis, PhD, Vice President of the Client Solutions Group here at Numerix. Tom, how are you?
Good, thank you, Jim.
Thank you for joining us. Over the past couple of months, it's been pretty stable out there, and one could argue that it's been a bull market. But given recent events, we've seen a wide upswing in the fear index, and that means volatility is back. Tom, I want to sit and talk to you, and just over the past couple of weeks, and clearly as it relates to news of the potential for the U.S. To default on its debt, we've seen a very quiet VIX sitting around 16, jump up to 20, now sitting around today around back down to 15. In terms of modeling as it relates to the valuation of derivatives, give us a little background of what should modelers be thinking about in terms of model selection and best practices as volatility is coming back to the marketplace.
We see the dynamics in the VIX over the past couple of weeks. There's a couple of interesting things I want to talk about, but it definitely we need to ensure that our models for the markets capture this stochastic volatility and the dynamics of stochastic volatility. Usually in the past, when you look at the VIX versus the S&P, you see a strong negative correlation, almost minus 0.6 or so, which means in down markets you have more volatility. But it's really interesting in the past couple months that we see a very flat S&P, but yet, as you say, the volatility seems to be jumping up with the VIX. And one of the hallmarks of the Heston model, which is the stochastic volatility model, is this mean reverting feature of the VIX, of the volatility. And actually we see that, as you said, it jumped up, and then but later, when the markets didn't correct downward, the volatility index came back to its mean reverting behavior.
So under the assumption that there's a robust model validation within internal departments and as it relates to kind of OCC guidelines that have come out around model validation, what kind of testing should people be looking at and with kind of what regularity at this point in time? Is this, you know, with the potential that this could just be a hiccup if, you know, everything goes back to normal within the U.S.? But, you know, what kind of testing should people be looking at?
Definitely looking at historical back testing, which means how did your different models perform over different periods of time. And you look at different things like what model's best in the crisis, what model's best in normal markets. And at this point, it's still not a crisis market. So it's you should be looking, when you do your model validation for your volatility models, for now, you should be looking at normal market behavior and looking at your option prices and your volatility and how it did track and your hedging portfolios, how they did track throughout the normal market conditions.
Okay. And what would facilitate a change? I mean, clearly, you know, external events, but is there something within the correlation, because we are in such a weird uncorrelated market between the S&P and the VIX, at what point should we be looking at changes?
Right. The one thing with the model is I like to say that if you ever observe any observable in the market, you will find it to be stochastic. So one thing that we don't put into the modeling right now is the correlation. You can put in a term structure, which means you can monitor or predict how the correlation can change over time. However, that's not a stochastic variable. The Heston model is a two-factor. And so it's not really under consideration to make the correlation stochastic, but it's one thing for sure is that you should test your models with different levels of correlation. Traditionally, we'd always put it a negative. So just to see how your model reacts when it comes up to uncorrelated behavior like we're seeing now. You'll always see the mean reverting behavior, so that has to be a hallmark of your model when you do your validation.
Tom, I want to thank you so much for the insight. And you know what, as this progresses, well, let's keep an eye on the correlation and keep this conversation going, because Lord only knows, we might be at another point in change. So follow along. We want to hear what you have to say and talk about the topics you want to talk about. Please feel free to join us and follow us on LinkedIn, at Backus on Twitter, at NX Analytics. And please feel free to connect with Tom on LinkedIn or myself to stay on top of all the information that we put out into the market. With that, I'm Jim Jockel. Have a good day.